In today's video, we're going to look at how to resize the columns and rows in Excel to make your data just that bit more readable. As with lots of things in Excel, there are several ways of doing this, and we're going to start with the easiest and quickest. What we're going to do is we're going to select all our data by clicking in the top left here. Then we're going to move to between any two columns, and you'll see that the cursor changes to a black cross. Double click, all the columns spring out to the width of the longest piece of data in them. That might be all you need to do to make your sheet readable. It gives you all the information without having to click into individual cells to see it. I'm also going to show you another couple of ways that you can resize and manipulate your columns and rows. The first one is just manually dragging the column to the desired size. To do this, again, we come up to between the two columns and we go to the right of the column that we want to resize. So in this instance, I'll be resizing column A. I click on the mouse button, hold it down, and I just simply drag the cursor to whatever size I want the column to be, so that could be longer or shorter. The third way you can change the width of columns is to right-click and go into the column width setting. The measurements in the column width are a tiny bit confusing because they're based on the number of characters Microsoft define in the normal font. So this is the default font up here that appears in a new spreadsheet. This is saying we can fit just under 31 characters in this column. It's not a particularly meaningful number for most people, but you can base it on, for example, if you wanted to copy the same size of another column, you could just use that as a unit of measurement to do that. Similarly, everything that I've shown you can be done at row level. So again, we could select all our data, and if we wanted to change the height of our rows, we could double click between the two of the rows. We can manually drag the height of a row to change it. And again, we can right click and go into row height and adjust it. Now, this unit of measurement is different, and this is based on the number of points. There is a definition of what a point is. Again, it's not a particularly meaningful measure for most people. Basically, this will accommodate a font size of up to 26 points. I hope that helps with making your data more readable. Please like and subscribe to my channel if you want more Excel hints. Thank you very much for watching.